where they shouldn't be. News Channel 8's Cynthia Fodor shows us Des Moines police have been on the hunt for those parked cars today. Cynthia.
That's right, Stacey. People are getting better about moving their cars, particularly off those priority streets, but police are still writing hundreds of tickets.
Blake Brown looked out his window this afternoon to find his car being tagged.
I decided to come out, make sure they weren't taking my car away.
Did you know that it was parked here illegally?
I didn't know that you couldn't park more than 24 hours in one spot.
It seems a lot of people are not aware of a city ordinance that you can't park in one spot for more than one day.
There are a lot of cars on the side streets that aren't on snow routes that do get left for long periods of time.
So Sergeant Dave Mulford and others spent the day tagging the cars.
During the summer, I do the same thing. It's just easier to do in the snow. And because of you can see where the snow plows have gone around the cars and they haven't moved and they're plowed in.
So the snow sort of marks them for you.
Yes, it does.
In the winter, buried vehicles make it difficult for plows and traffic on the street.
This red tag will give you 24 hours to move your car. If it's still here at the same time tomorrow, police will either ticket it or tow it.
In the last 2 days, police have given out 201 tickets along snow routes, only 25 in the new snow ordinance neighborhoods. That's compared with 319 on snow routes and 569 in priority neighborhoods after our first snowfall last month. The numbers indicate more motorists are heeding the message to move parked cars off priority streets.
That's the deal we've made here, is that if we keep the cars off, they'll go and do this super plowing. Mm-hmm. And it's outstanding.
John Hoyam is thrilled that side streets in his Waterbury neighborhood are now cleared quickly.
Boy, yesterday was clear, just absolutely super to drive on. So, yeah, I'm very happy with it.
The city expects they'll be towing quite a few cars tomorrow. And interestingly enough, police actually find quite a few stolen vehicles, which